Hi, I'm Sarah from Knitting-and.com. Today I'm going to show you how to sew buttons onto knit or crocheted fabric. When you sew a button with a shank onto a knit or crochet garment, you don't need to do anything special because there's already enough room for your fabric to fit between the button and the garment when you do the buttons up. When you sew on a flat button, however, you need to create a shank as you sew the button on. If you don't, your buttons will keep popping open. Aside from your buttons, you'll need a sharp needle for sewing, yarn or embroidery floss. Don't be tempted to use sewing thread if your yarn is too thick to go through the holes in your buttons. Sewing thread will wear through your yarn and it'll make holes in your knitting. You'll also need a match or a thick darning needle. You'll sew over the top of this to create a gap between the button and the garment. So the thicker your fabric is, the thicker you'll need this to be. I use a darning needle for DK weight wool, which is 8-ply in Australia, and a match for worsted weight, or what we call 12-ply in Australia. Using the sharp needle and yarn or floss, make 3 stitches on top of each other on the wrong side of your work to anchor the thread. If you have a ribbed button band, you can stitch through a knit stitch, as I have here. Push the needle through to the right side of your knitting, the front, the side that people see. And through one of the holes on your button. Here's my button. Place your match or darning needle across the front of the button like this. Now you're going to sew the button on over the top of the needle. Sew the button on, making sure to go over the match or darning needle. Sew through each hole at least 2 or 3 times. There you can see I've sewn my button on over the top of the darning needle. After you've finished sewing the button on, bring the needle back through to the front of the work, but this time you're not going to go through the button. Now you can take out the darning needle or match, whichever you used. Now wind the yarn around underneath the button 2 or 3 times to make those threads into a more secure shank. Pull it quite tight, but make sure you don't break your thread. Next, put the needle back through to the back. Make 3 more stitches to fasten off your yarn. That's my 3rd stitch. And trim your thread, and you're done. And when you do up the buttons, they won't pop open. Next week I'm going to show you how to make a safe and long-lasting Play-Doh for children and grown-ups too.